Hello friends, in my last video I had explained you regarding key factors needed to be given utmost attention for positive starting of ME engines. If at all you have missed the video, please go through the link attached in the description below. In today's video, I'll describe you the procedures for recording performance of ME engines and provide you knowledge essential to understanding the concept, structure and function of the PMI system. Basically, the main engine performance is taken in order to ensure optimal mechanical condition of engine components and optimal overall plant economy. To achieve precise readings during performance test, ensure your vessel is on even keel and preferably on full load condition. The sea should be calm and depth greater than 4 times its mean draft. The engine must be operated above 85% of maximum continuous rating. Now, to start with, ME engines are provided with a PMI system for performance evaluation. PMI is pressure measuring instrument. There are two different types of versions of PMI system. First is online PMI system, also known as COCOS EDS, Computer Control Surveillance Engine Diagnostic System. On online PMI system, a pressure measuring transducer is installed on the indicator cocks of cylinder heads, continuously conveying all the measurements on the PC display in engine control room. This system keeps the operating personnel informed at all the times of engine condition with relevant data. The second one is the offline PMI version. In this system, there is a high performance piezoelectric transducer which needs to be mounted manually on the cylinder head indicator cocks, from which the cylinder pressure is measured. The transducer has to be manually moved from one cylinder to another between each set of measurements. The transducer is connected to the PMI controller. Your vessel will be installed with a PMI DAU, that is Data Acquisition Unit. On both the online and offline systems, the measured data by the pressure transducer sensor is transmitted to PMI DAU. Now, the Ethernet cable further conveys all the data to the PC in the engine control room. Also, the angle encoder fitted on the free end of the main engine crankshaft detects the absolute position of the crankshaft angle and conveys signal to ECU, the engine control unit, and data acquisition unit via the TACO system. Now, as you are familiar with the basic elements of the performance recording system, I will demonstrate you step-by-step procedures for conducting the performance test. My vessel has an offline PMI system analyzer with a separate laptop for monitoring. So, in order to conduct performance test, increase the main engine RPM up to 85% MCR. For my ship, it's 82 RPM. Let the engine run for 15 minutes so that the parameters are stable. First, you need to connect the network cable from data acquisition unit to the laptop. To start the PMI system, double click on the PMI icon. Then, following page will be displayed. And select the maintenance icon and select tools in the top menu. Then go to others on the display and select run wizard. Your screen will display following page with a message in flickering mode. No connection to the PMI DAU unit. Now you need to set up the connection between the PMI data acquisition unit and the PMI controller. For this, you need to attach the given cable at the junction box. check the direction of the pins. Once you connect the cable at the junction box, connect the another end of the cable to the PMI controller. You can see the power light goes on. Now you need to connect the PMI transducer to the PMI controller. After this, press the OK button on the PMI controller and your PMI calibration box is ready to measure the pressures inside the cylinder head. Once you set up the connection between the junction box, PMI controller and the transducer, your laptop display will indicate ready to measure on the left corner of the page. Now proceed to the engine. Friends, before mounting the transducer on the indicator cocks, make sure you always blow through the carbon deposits inside the gas passage on the indicator cock. This is done in order to prevent any damage to the sensor inside the transducer. After you carry out the blow through, connect the transducer on the indicator cock. Make sure there is no gas leakage at the connection. And then open the indicator cock. Press OK on the PMI calibration box. Once you press OK button, the transducer measures the pressure inside the cylinder and via data acquisition unit conveys the signal to the laptop in ECR. The PMI software version converts the measured signal into different graphic views. A pressure versus crank angle diagram of the respective unit will be displayed on the screen. Now shut the indicator cock and disconnect the transducer and move to the next unit and follow the steps as explained earlier. After recording all the readings of the units, press next on the right corner of the display. A comment page will pop up. Enter date, loaded ballast condition and RPM of the vessel for later reference. Then press finish on the right corner. Once you select finish, all the data will be saved and you will return back to main page. In order to transfer the file of the measured data, open the PMI Auto-Tuning folder. Then go to Measurements. Select the required file. All the readings will be displayed on the main page. Now select Report on the top menu. A print measurement report page will be displayed. Select the items you need to print. Here I will select all to view graphic presentation. Then select print on the right corner of the page. The PMI software program will convert the readings to selected graphic pages. A print page will be displayed. Now select the name of the printer as Microsoft XPS Document Writer. Then again select print on the right corner. You can save the file on the desktop or any other folder. Name the file again and then enter save. The file will be saved in the selected folder in XPS document format. Now you can copy the file on a pen drive and transfer it to another computer. Friends, this is very important. During the process of this measurement, you need to take due precaution while handling the cable of the transducer. The connections are delicate and the transducer can malfunction if you handle it roughly. Never hold the cable with the weight of the transducer on it. It is always advisable to secure the cable at the top with an electric cable tag. Guys, hope the video has familiarized you with the procedures for main engine performance recording. Please do like and share this video with your friends and colleagues. Also, subscribe my channel for more informative videos on ME engines. Thank you for watching. Wish you a safe sailing.